held in check.
Really, and West Virginia doing a good job banging past Moore, making him earn every catch he has.
Mark Cann with waiting for a game like this, and after tough losses the last two games. Third down for Cann. And the catch is made by Emmanuel Spann, and he's going to be close to the first down marker as they mark it at the West Virginia 48-yard line. Let's see, they're going to, I think, call for a measurement here. If he didn't get it, it'll be a fourth and short. And I think, without a doubt, you're in four down territory now, down 24-3. Bring the sticks out. And just short. So fourth and a few chain links for Marshall. And they'll bring in the big bodies here for the short yardage play.
You know, Marshall's playing like they really have an opportunity here, and that's the best thing to do. I don't see any quit in the thundering herd, trailing by 21, a whole quarter to go. A lot of things can happen.
Coach Schneider knows they've got to have it. Already down by 21. Can a big body straight ahead at 6'4", 238 pounds. And we have a timeout before the play. 24-3 West Virginia. Marshall facing a fourth down and inches, coming off of a timeout. They're at the West Virginia 48-yard line. Lone setback, Darius Marshall. Toss sweep to the short side of the field. Has a first down and more. And he's inside the 40 before being run out of bounds. Ian Smith, the free safety, on the tackle. Just haven't seen enough of Marshall today.
Well, you know, he has some outstanding performances the last couple of weeks. 112 yards and a touchdown against Southern Mississippi. 27 totes for 140 yards and a touchdown against Memphis. Today, he only has 13 carries for about 40 yards and maybe another couple of catches. So it's way off his performance. Slade has been down, and so has caught Passmore and kept him in check for just a couple of grabs so far this afternoon.
Just underway here in the fourth quarter. First down at the West Virginia 39. They have Slate in a slot to the right side. Cann looking left, corner of the end zone, and incomplete. He wanted Passmore with Langster trailing him. That's something we thought we'd see a lot more of, stretching the field with Passmore and his 4-3 speed.
You know, this is just outstanding, step for step, and Langster just keeps that hand on him, and that is legal, just to know where the receiver is, where he is, and looks back at the appropriate time. Passmore just could not put separation between him and Langster, and just incomplete pass, but good defensive effort by Langster.
He had six catches for 128 yards and a touchdown against Memphis, over 130 yards against Southern Miss, but it's been held in check here tonight. Four catches, just 39 yards over the middle. Catch made by Lee Smith, the tight end. And he bounces off one tackle, and he's close to a first down inside the 30. As you can see, on third and short, handoff, or a toss pitch to Darius Marshall. He has a first down. Reed Williams, middle linebacker, on the tackle. So they move the sticks, and they're getting Marshall a little bit more involved here, but the clock running, and that's an ally of the Mountaineers.
He's far off where he's been. He's had three 100-yard performances thus far, but again, West Virginia's kept him in check, just over 40 yards rushing. And he's made a couple of good runs at outstanding kickoff return, but not enough as the Thundering Herd trail at 21.
Spann, Milligan, Passmore, Slate. All split out with Marshall in the backfield. In the flat, through the hands of Marshall, and incomplete. You know, even with a catch there, you're not getting more than a couple yards, as West Virginia had a defender right there in JT Thomas.
And Marshall is really just trying to make a big play. Last year, he had a little case of the drops, and it's not happened this year. He's held onto the ball, but just tried to make a play and turn and run before he really caught the ball. And JT Thomas in coverage, a linebacker, that tells you a lot about how quick the West Virginia linebackers are covering running backs and receivers, single coverage.
Let's see if that play sets up a pass downfield here. They've got Passmore and Slate to the top of the screen. They're two weapons. Pump fake right now over the middle. Slate, it's deflected and incomplete. He takes a big time hit, and that's going to get flagged. That will be a personal foul penalty on Ian Smith, the free safety.
And I think he got a penalty because a shot to the head, or he used his helmet. Watch this right here. What a collision. Right to the head. That is what got him the penalty.
Personal foul. Low to the head on the defense, number 24. 15-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
That's automatic, Trey, from, you know, this year. They've watched that very closely. And Ian Smith, if he makes a tackle, hits him in the chest. But because he went to the head, automatic 15.
Well, he got his money's worth on that one. But it's dangerous when you're up near the headgear. And the officials will call that 99% of the time.
Mm-hmm. And that was a good call.
First down at the Mountaineers 14. Can tipped and incomplete, caught out of bounds. Passmore. Hogan got his hand on that one.
Hogan makes a great break as he comes out of that cut, sticks a, swats it away with his paw. And Hogan has played a pretty good game, just a sophomore. He'll be back for another couple of years. And well, he's one of the three true freshmen that played last year and did a good job.
Yeah, he's a slot receiver, made the move to cornerback in the offseason, and he called his number a lot tonight. Second down. Can over the middle. It's his tight end, Slate, and he's down to the six-yard line. A couple yards short of the first down. Quentin Andrews, the leading tackler at the safety spot on the stop there. Here's a look at number eight, junior from Opa-locka, Florida, three-year starter.
And Slate with his third grab of the game here with this a crossing pattern underneath, and they can let you have that. Marshall needs seven, not three, and they're going third and short here. Got to think it's a Marshall play. Darius Marshall.
14th play of this drive. There's a look on the third down numbers at the top there, 7 out of 13. In motion, Bryant Milligan. Can rolling left. Tight end's open, and it's through his hands. Through Slate's hands. It was a bullet thrown low. That would have been a good enough for a first down, though.
A little behind Slate. He had to make a tough catch. He was going forward. He had to turn back, bend back to make the catch. All his momentum is going forward. He's got to bend all the way around. This is not an easy catch at all. And of course, they converged on him quickly. But Slate usually makes those catches. That was a tough catch.
Fourth and a yard with under 12 minutes to go. They've converted one today. Passmore, the lone receiver, up top as they put Slate in motion. Pitch left, Marshall. Hit hard and drives forward, and I think he has it. Needed to get inside the five, and the spot looks like it's close to the four-yard line and would be good enough for the first down. That's hard running. He took a shot at the line of scrimmage.
He flies through the holes, and again, reminiscent of Ahmad Bradshaw. Slate.
See how close this is. It appeared that the football was up. Yep, good enough by about half the football. A first down at the four-yard line. 16 plays on the drive. How about this block by Passmore?
Right here by Slate. He just drives him. Look at this. He's driving him. That he just drives him about 15 yards. Well, not quite. I'm exaggerating. But he just keeps those feet moving and backs off when the referee steps in. But good block by Slate. He's not just a pass receiver. He's a good blocker.
The hard run by Marshall. Good enough for the first down at the four-yard line. Hurd trying to get in the end zone for the first time. Marshall hit the backfield and dropped. Reed Williams has been like a man possessed, the senior from Moorefield, West Virginia. And it's amazing to come back from one shoulder surgery, but how about surgery on both shoulders, Renee?
And this is the Fiesta Bowl defensive MVP filling this A-gap. Boy, he blows through there, and he's determined to make the stop. Read the play very quickly, diagnosed it, made the stop. That's the way a middle linebacker plays.
Over 100 tackles last year. Missed the first two games, makes a big play there, second and goal. Can And his receiver fell down. Pass more near the goal line.
Ball's incomplete. And third down.
You see pass more, and he just trips out of this break here and as in coverage with Brandon Hogan, who's done a really good job. But pass more just couldn't keep his feet under.
Rain starting to fall. You wonder if he lost some footing there. It's third and goal now.
The only receiver out in that coverage that time, in that pattern.
Edmondson and Passmore split to the bottom of the screen. Slate again in motion. Tan steps up, throws on the run, incomplete. Tough pass to make on the move. And through the hands of his intended receiver, Darius Passmore, it's fourth down. And they'll bring the kicking team out there.
Morty Ivey, you know, he was recruited as a 204-pound safety. He's grown into a 235-pound linebacker, but he's got that safety instincts. This is a guy who once played safety. He sees where the ball is, reacts very quickly, and Passmore is not an easy guy to stay with, but Morty Ivey makes sure he doesn't make the reception.
Warner has made one field goal, didn't get a chance at a second, that ended up being a pivotal play, a bad hold by the holder. Span. This kick is no good. Off to the left, hold on, there is a flag on the field at the 16. It's motion against the kicking team.
Legal formation on the offense. Penalties decline, no score. First down, Western.
24 to go, the Mountaineers have the football. Another long drive and no points for Marshall. They've had two long drives. Over 12 minutes of clock time burned off and no points. That's been, it made for a frustrating day for Coach Schneider. Here's Noel Devine on the carry across the 30 and a first down out to the 33-yard line. This guy has not had a frustrating day. Over the century mark for the second straight game, Noel Devine.
And he's close. He's close on 125 yards rushing. Listen to this. Patrick White leaves the game completing 81% of his tosses.
Let's revisit the keys for the Mountaineers, and they have done the job, haven't they?
Find the rhythm, get into a flow, finish drives they have. Need a new hero? They found one, and Jock Sanders always did. And contained the run, which they did, and Darius Passmore was one guy they needed to focus on, and they threw the ball down the field with effectiveness.
And the number three there, the Stars, they have come out to play, Devine and White. Sanders a nice third option, first down at the 33-yard line. Devine has averaged 10.6 yards per carry as he gets the handoff again, trying to dance his way away from trouble, nowhere to go. Ran out of room. If he had room, he'd probably make something happen, but it's a loss back to the 32.
Good block by Ryan Stanchak on the left side, left tackle. Guy making his 38th start out of Cincinnati, Ohio, and he'll probably be, you know, we talked about the talent out here. Next 2 years, there'll be about 25 to 28 guys that will get an opportunity to be in NFL camps. That is a lot of talent out here next 2 years.
We talked about the, you know, the 24 guys that went on to the NFL from that 1997 game. A lot of talent on the field here as well. In 2008, here's Devine, and he's corralled and dropped for a loss back at the 29. And here comes a flag. Johnny Jones, a defensive tackle.
Personal foul on the defense. Face mask. Number 91, 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's more of a collaring play there, but they're going to call it a face mask and a personal foul penalty.
Horse collar, they are also considering that, you know, that can hurt someone. So a horse collar.
Well, there at the end. But then at the end, he got the mask as well. So collar and the face mask. And the coach, Coach Schneider on the far side, not too pleased with Jones on that play.
Johnny Jones, just a sophomore, 6'5", 288, and got a bright future here for the Thundering Herd.
Approaching 9-minute mark, Coach Schneider seeing this game slip away. They have not been able to generate much offensively. Here's Brown to the air, downfield at Sanders. He's got it inside the 30, and another big play for Jock Sanders. Well, who is going to step out behind White and Devine? They may have found their guy in the sophomore Sanders.
Jarrett Brown with great touch as Jock Sanders gets beyond the coverage, making his eighth grab, bumped out of bounds, but the damage is already done, and Jock Sanders is enjoying his career day here.
Eight catches, 60 yards. Last year, he had 12 catches, rushed the ball 16 yards for a couple scores. multi-dimensional threat for the Mountaineers. At the 27, handoff to Devine, in some trouble, tries to reverse his field, keeps the feet going, and he still will lose yardage back to the 28.
Boy, Trey, he's got a little jello on his boots, doesn't he, buddy?
Safe to say he's not a north-south guy.
Wow,
huh?
Man. He'll go 55 yards to gain three.
Fun to watch, though. Gamble, the senior on the tackle. 5'9", 185. You think he's 5'9", Renee?
You know, standing on his tiptoes. But he's a pack of dynamite. Again, he bench presses over 400 pounds. And, you know, when he hits you, you feel it.
Over 400 total yards of offense now for West Virginia. Second down, 12 at the Herd 29-yard line. Brown, they can run all the way. It's a good block. He's inside the 25, and then he's hammered by Daquan Bembry, the corner near the stick. Some hitting going on here in the last 7:40+ in this one. Sanders with a big block on the sideline.
A pair of good blocks in space. Sanders was one of them. And you see right here, Sanders, bang. Meet number 9, Jock Sanders. Wes Lyons is also applying a block downfield. So Jarrett Brown, a nice escort as they close to a 3rd and 2.
Just shy of the 28-yard line. Brown, a play fake this time to Devine. He's under duress, throws off his back foot to the pylon. Incomplete. Broken up by John Saunders, the strong safety. Arnett was the intended receiver, and he took a shot. You know, we talked about it. Mark Snyder said it's not going to be friendly out there on Saturday, and we've seen hitting from every angle in this one.
You got to come away impressed with Jarrett Brown, what he's done. He collects himself. He throws on the run pretty effectively. Nice spiral, throws an easy catch, and as Jarrett Brown is getting instructions on the sidelines. But you have to be very encouraged by what he's done here this afternoon.
Okay, here's McAfee from 36 yards. Converted on his last attempt. Plenty of leg on this one. And he knocks it through there. And a guy that's been trying to you love rushing the football when you have a lead, and they have done that successfully. Darius Marshall on the kick return. And Marshall has some room across the 40. Into West Virginia territory. Kicker to beat. It's McAfee again. And eerily similar to earlier in the game. They'll officially make that a 64-yard return, but two big kickoff returns. Marshall fumbles the football. Loose on the ground and recovered by the backup quarterback, Brian Anderson, that has checked in. Sophomore from Louisville is the only guy with a start at quarterback entering the season. He's only thrown 6 passes this year.
Out of Louisville, Kentucky, Brian Anderson, 6'3", 217. He's similar to Cann a little bit, but he was number 3 rated quarterback coming out of Kentucky. Number 10th rated overall play out of Kentucky, but good career. 24 touchdowns.
Back up to Bernard Morris last year. To the air, and the pass incomplete as he was looking for Courtney Edmison in the vicinity of the 10-yard line. So Cann is out of there, a frustrating day for him. Anderson, a guy that saw time in 5 games a year ago. And a chance to get some work here, some reps in the final 6 minutes.
They got a new tailback, Terrell Edwards, out of Mobile, Alabama. And a 49-yard touchdown run against Illinois State. He's a walk-on. They think he could be special down the road, just a freshman.
Third down is empty the backfield. Quarterback draw by Anderson. Hit hard as he takes it down to the 18, shy of the stick. Quentin Andrews laid into him right there with a big-time hit. Known as a big hitter, showed it right there. Here comes fourth down.
And that's what something that is missing from Marshall. That's not something that Cann did, Anderson did. You got to be mobile. You got to have something out of that, a threat as a running quarterback. And I think Cann certainly can do it. They maybe instructed him not to, but well, he took a hit from Quentin Andrews, who had 15 tackles, Quentin Andrews against Colorado. Big time hitter.
4th and 2. Marshall still trying to find the end zone. They've had a couple long drives, 16 and 19 play drives and no points. Flag is thrown. Here's Edwards on the carry, and he's shut down shy of the marker at the line of scrimmage. Final
Legal formation on the offense. Only six players on the line of scrimmage. Penalties declined. First down, West Virginia.
So West Virginia takes over on downs. Morty Ivy. Boy, have their linebackers been awesome today. Ivy, Williams, and Thomas, left to right, have made the plays, and they expect to make the plays. The linemen have set them up pretty well.
Haven't seen much of Laser, who played quite a bit in the absence of Reed Williams, a young player, should be good. But JT Thomas and Holmes, another guy played a little bit, Reed Williams, Ivy, Goldburn, another one. They have some of the best core of linebackers in this team than you'll see anywhere in the country.
Well, this really has to give West Virginia a shot in the arm. You know, after a loss at East Carolina where they really dominated, lost that game 24-3. Heartbreaking overtime loss at Colorado. And I think it's safe to say they got a little swagger back here. Not all the way back, but it's a good start as they look down the rest of their schedule. Handoff to Mark Rogers, the freshman from Lawndale, California, for a short gain. But it's Big East play. Coming up next, Rutgers and Syracuse, and then you mentioned Auburn. That'll be a tough test for them.
That'll be tough, and Auburn is a team that really needs a win, and we'll see what happens between now and then. But no easy games, and you can see what's happened against Florida, Ole Miss, Southern Cal on Thursday night. College football, not for the faint of heart, and it's going to want to be in a topsy-turvy kind of season, much like 2007.
And I think this is fun. This is what a lot of people want to see. It's exciting. Here's Rogers on the carry, and a big gain across the 30. Rogers upended at the 37-yard line. Rogers runs a 10-5 100 meters. He was clocked at that. Fourth best in the entire state of California coming out of high school.
He had 2,300 yards his senior season. He runs a lot like a Divine. You know, his style is very similar. Makes his cuts at full speed. Not a big guy, 5'9", 185. But he's got a couple of touchdowns rushing this year. And they think he can certainly be special. And when he comes in, you really don't, there's not much of a drop-off.
Well, they're glad to have him. He originally committed to Portland State out of high school, stayed home for a year, and that opened up the door to other schools, including West Virginia. And they offered him, and they're glad to have him. Nice guy behind the likes of Divine and Sanders. And he's hit this time, and he's dropped for a loss back at the 36-yard line. Ashton Hall, the junior, strong safety on the play. Hall, a guy that started seven games a year ago, backing up Aaron Johnson this year.
Well, Sammy Marone, the tight end, just pancaked the Marshall player. Wow.
Yeah, there's been hitting going on. A lot of it we see out on the periphery, out in the open field, but down on the line of scrimmage, a lot of hitting as well. You'd expect it from these two rivals. Second down. Brown on the keeper. Open field running, and Brown has some room. Into Marshall territory. Brown to the 33, and he's upended right there. Tackle made from behind by Ahmed Shakur, the freshman cornerback, but he looked a little bit like Noel Devine in terms of ad-libbing his way through some trouble.
You know, Kellen Harris, linebacker, had two shots at him and missed, whiffed on both opportunities. You know, he caught him coming and caught him going. And you see, watch, number 35, Jarrett Brown's going one way. 35, misses the man. Now watch, he gets up and misses him a second time. That's got to be frustrating. He's a good runner, and Jarrett Brown is out to clear, trying to get a little help downfield blocking, but a nice run by the backup quarterback.
44 yards later, first down at the 29 of Marshall. Brown's done a nice job in relief of White. Handoff to Rogers. Rogers picking his way to the outside, and he's knocked down at the 24-yard line. 5 yards on that carry. Ashton Hall again on the tackle. He's kind of in the same mold of as a Divine, 5'9", about 185. Those small backs kind of fit into that spread offense.
Coming into this game, Trey, West Virginia had 110 plays on the ground, 67 plays through the air. Rushing, they averaged 5.8 yards per, passing 6.8 per. You know, I think there was predominantly running success today, but it shows that they are throwing the ball a little bit more, and they did have some success throwing today.
474 yards of total offense. Final 2 minutes here for Morgantown. Rogers again running left. Rogers a seam to the 10. And they have a first and goal from there. He showed a burst right there, Renee. He turned it into another gear when he got past the line of scrimmage. Mike Dent, the center, with a good block.
He gets to the second level very quickly into the defensive backfield. Good cut, cuts at full speed, and he's going to come. You can see right here, cuts off a block. Stanchek with a good block, 62. Good kick out block there, and he's cutting off at full speed, making good moves and running downhill. Boy, a good run by Rogers.
Hall again on the tackle. Over 2,300 yards rushing as a senior. Where, yeah, that's a lot of running. And they like his future at West Virginia. We get the carry here, slanting right and down to the 5-yard line. It'll be second and goal from that point as we near the 1-minute mark. For Marshall, it's been disappointing. It has to be, coming off a great win at Southern Miss. A reality check here against a good football team.
But, you know, they pick up and they go back to, you know, what they have an opportunity to do. And, you know, next they play Cincinnati. Possibility that could be a win for them, or certainly a winnable game. UAB, Houston, East Carolina. It doesn't get any easier. They finish up the season against UCF, Rice, and Tulsa. But, again, they've played well. They played well against Wisconsin and lost. They beat Southern Miss last week, and they certainly have the weapons and the talent to play with all of those schools.
Jarrett Brown will take a knee here. The final 20.